Hello everyone, it is January. That is my sister, who is gonna be my co-pilot today. And yeah, we are at the, oh my god, that is a lot of people. We are actually at Hong Kong Disneyland. We actually just came from New Zealand and we had a layover in Hong Kong for like 23 hours. And we were like, what better thing to do than go to Hong Kong Disneyland and try World of Frozen for the first time. I'm so excited. I've been wanting to go to World of Frozen since they announced it. Frozen is one of my favorite Disney movies. And yeah, we are at the iconic arch and we are about to make our way into the park. And I hope you guys follow along. So we just passed the iconic arch over there. And now we're headed to the iconic Mickey water fountain that just spritz out water. He's like on a whale. And the whale spurts out water and Mickey's riding on it, which is pretty cool. But now we're gonna go to the park. We have early entry to World of Frozen, so I'm gonna tell you a little bit about early entry. I think it's only available right now until Feb 29 this year. I don't know if they're gonna continue it past that, but it essentially allows you access to the entire World of Frozen and some of the Fantasyland rides, including Winnie the Pooh, if I remember. So if seeing World of Frozen is your priority, which it should be if you're gonna be in Hong Kong Disneyland for the next few, probably like months, you should definitely try to get that. I think it's worth it. And it's not that expensive from what I remember. So yeah, so we just went through security. In case you guys do pick early entry, the line for that is on the left. And I don't think I've shown you my outfit. I am in a blue pants and a purple top because I'm Anna. And my sister's Elsa.
Hi.
Yes, so we're about to enter. They already started letting people in, so that's pretty great. We are in the park, we are in the park. Oh my god, we're gonna see World of Frozen. And also, I'm very excited to see the Dreammaker statue, which is the Walt statue. Oh my, I forget how gorgeous Hong Kong Disneyland is. And yeah, so we are gonna book it to World of Frozen right now. Early entry starts in 5 minutes. And our hope is to be able to do both Frozen Ever After and Wandering Oaken Sliding Slays twice. But as I've said before in my other vlogs, I will not be recording my first ride through of both rides because I want to just soak it in, you know. This is like the first time I'm attending a new land opening in Hong Kong Disneyland since Mystic Manor opened almost 11 years ago, so I really want to like savor it, you know. So yeah, but we're about to see the castle. Oh my god,
look at her,
she's stunning. Look at that, literally stunning. It's amazing. That is it, everyone. The Castle of Magical Dreams. But we are about to see the Arendelle Palace and Elsa's Ice Castle in a bit. Let's go. There's the Dreammaker statue. They took out Sword in the Stone to put it there though. So that's kind of sad.
Oh.
But we're headed now to World of Frozen and celebrate Summer Snow Day. Happy Summer Snow
Day. Happy Summer Snow Day.
Okay, I'm gonna take more videos for my TikTok later because we are kind of rushing right now. And we have about 4 hours after lunch to just explore World of Frozen. So, I'm sorry if you can't see me right now. I think I'm very much backlit. But yes. Oh my god! Oh my god!
No, what if I cry?
Oh my god! First impressions, it is small. But it is beautiful. Oh my god.
The clock.
There's the clock from Love is an Open Door. And there's Arendelle Castle to the right. And Wandering Oaken Sliding Slays to the left. I mean to the right as well, sorry. I have no sense of direction. Oh my god, look at this. I am hyped, beyond hyped right now. So we're gonna go on Frozen Ever After. I won't record any of the QR lines, so I'll see you guys after this. Just got off Frozen Ever After. That was stunning, beautiful, amazing, best thing. Oh my god, what did you think?
I cried.
It was so good.
The drop wasn't as bad as I thought.
Yeah, people online were like saying like, oh, the drop is like really steep. It was steep, but it was not that
steep for a boat ride, but not for like a drop.
Yeah, the Pirates of the Caribbean one is probably even worse. But now we're in TikTok Toys and Collectibles, and we're gonna try and get on Frozen Ever After again. And this time I'll actually record it. So we are back in line for Frozen Ever After, and I'm going to show you a little bit of the queue, because the queue is fantastic, it's like amazing. So this is like Kristoff, Ice Master and Deliverer. area, and we're gonna see a little bit of the ice later on. But yeah, here are the carrots for Sven. And we are just winding our way through the queue right now. I don't know where. Okay, we're near the merge point, which is this. If I remember correctly, that is. Oaken sliding sleighs now. We will, why am I wearing a mask? We're gonna head, probably ride it once and then one more time later today, if we have time. But yeah, let's go over there. So we are now headed to Wandering Oaken sliding sleighs. As like I said before, I will not take a video of this because I want to experience it, like soak it all in for the first time. So yes, but we're gonna go on and I'll tell you all about it afterwards.
Hello! I like the warm hugs too, yeah?
There's a mad dash of people running towards Frozen Ever After, which is hilarious. But we rode it twice. Wandering Oaken's was pretty good. For a coaster of that length, it was very well detailed. Great views of the land. It was amazing, actually, for a coaster. For a family-style junior coaster. I mean, is it Space Mountain? No. Is it Big Thunder Mountain? No. It's not even Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, but it was still very good in my opinion. For, like I said, for its size. So yeah, we're gonna leave Frozen Land for a while now. Try to hit up all the other rides in the park while everyone is literally, you can see them all rushing behind me. Everyone is now here, so we are gonna go and do some of the other rides. Let me show you guys this fountain really quick. Look at it. It's amazing. It's Elsa! Thank you. So we're exiting Frozen Land for a while. We'll be back at like maybe like 1:30. And now we're about to do every other ride that we wanted to ride while we're here, which is Mystic Manor, Toy Soldier Parachute Drop, Grizzly, Big Grizzly Mountain Runaway Mine Cars, The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh, It's a Small World, Space Mountain, and Ant-Man. So let's go. At The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh. Let's go. It's not real. My sister has an Olumel on her arm
and
an Olumel on her bag. The biggest Olumel fan. So we just left my parents for a bit because we're going to
Space Mountain.
We're going to Space Mountain. Hyperspace Mountain, as they say. This is exactly like the one in California, because California becomes Hyperspace Mountain in like April to May, for May the 4th basically. So we are going there, and it's exactly the same. Like, it's exactly the same. Actually, I would think this one is a little better. The projections are clearer than the ones at Disneyland. And yeah, it's just great. So we're on our way there. We are in, there's the X-Wing. We are in Hyperspace Mountain, making our way over there. This should be very fun. For some reason, I get dizzier on this version rather than the one in California. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the vehicles or something. I don't know. But yeah. I really love the planetary stuff here. I still think Disneyland Space Mountain loading area is better, but this is pretty nice. Think about it. Tomorrowland is like empty right now, except for Orbitron for some reason. The line for Orbitron looks like it's like 30 minutes long. Meanwhile, no one is an Ant-Man, which is where we're gonna go next. We are in Ant-Man and the Wasp Nano Battle, which we used to be Buzz Lightyear Astro Blaster, but they changed it to Marvel because they also added Iron Man Experience, which opened in 2016. And yeah, we're gonna get on the ride now. Attention volunteers. Ant-Man and the Wasp Nano Battle, as you probably saw. And my gun wasn't working, actually. That score that you saw was actually my sister's. I just was like taking videos the whole time, which is fine. I don't feel the need to like play it. I just wanted to like ride through it. So now we're gonna head to Toy Story Land. We're basically gonna do a figure eight. We're gonna go to Toy Story Land, Mystic Manor, Grizzly Gulch, down to Jungle Cruise, up to Small World, and back to Frozen Land, where we will hopefully have lunch. Yeah, it's gonna be a great day. Got myself a Mickey ice cream bar. And now we're walking to Toy Story Land, which is on the other side of the park. We're gonna leisurely walk there. We are at the other side of the park from Tomorrowland. And now we are going to Toy Story Land, Mystic Point, and Grizzly Gulch. Hopefully the line for Toys Hold Your Parachute Drop isn't long. I'm expecting everyone to still be at Frozen Land at this time. Or maybe slowly they're making their way out. So, should be good. I really like that there's this like spirit jersey everyone is wearing that says Hong Kong Disneyland at the back. I really want it. Like, you have no idea how much I want it. But yeah, we're gonna try to find it. So, it should be somewhere here. I saw people like posting about it, so it should be somewhere here.
Don't worry,
we will find it. So Toy Soldier Parachute Drop said it was a 20-minute wait, but the line was outside the main barrack thing. And usually if it's there, it's like 30 minutes. So not really worth it for a ride that lasts 45 seconds. And basically just takes you up and down. So we're going to Mystic Manor instead. This is my first Hong Kong Disneyland vlog. So I don't think I mentioned this before, but Mystic Manor is my all-time favorite Disney ride. Like, I've probably ridden over this, like, throughout every single Disney park, over 100 rides. This one, for me, is the absolute best. And it's also in my favorite park. Not the best park. My favorite park, because it's the one I grew up with. But yeah, we are in line for Mystic Manor. I am very, very excited. I didn't think I would be back here actually this soon since our June trip. But yeah. To get the spirit jersey that I wanted. I'll show it to you guys later. And I'm trying to get the Dream Makers pin right now. So, yeah. So, update on what just happened. I lost my shades, like these shades. These are like clippable shades. And I lost them for like 10 minutes. I paid for my spirit jersey, my Albert plushie, and my pin, Dream Makers pin. And I couldn't find it in my pocket. So I went all over the store, couldn't find it, went to the exit of the ride, asked the cast member there, and she was like, actually, my dad has the same one, so I showed it, and then they were like, oh, I've seen this before, and then she goes into like a thing, pulls a box out, and inside are my shades. So, crisis averted, basically. Oh, what happened at the train station here? Anyway, now we're going to Grizzly Gulch. We are now in Grizzly Gulch. Probably my second favorite area of the park, or now third favorite after Mystic Point. That's the roller coaster. Okay, we're going. That was so good as always. The backward section, the launch, all good. There's a pretty little area here called Geyser Gulch, which basically has a bunch of water play areas. Kinda cute. But now we're on our way to the Jungle River Cruise. Yeah, in the Hong Kong, the Jungle Cruise is actually called the Jungle River Cruise because it goes around the Rivers of Adventure, which is a replacement for the Rivers of America because there's no frontier land here. Yeah, which should take us about 5 minutes to walk there. So, pro tip, one of the unique things you can buy here at Hong Kong Disneyland, you can find it here in Adventureland, in this particular stall right next to Theater in the Wild and Press Reporters Trading Post. Korean squid. And it's pretty good. I think I read somewhere that this is actually the largest Adventureland anywhere in the world, which is, I think, pretty cool. But now we are at the Jungle River Cruise. So we just rode Jungle River Cruise. It's my favorite version of the Jungle Cruise. I haven't ridden the updated Tokyo one, but my favorite section of this whole thing, the fire and the water gods fighting at the end, the fire and water both weren't working. So Disney, refurb this ride, please. But yeah, now we're gonna make our way to It's a Small World. So I'm not sure if you can hear it, but the cavalcade just passed by over there. And now we're at It's a Small World. I forgot how long it takes to walk through this entire queue, right? Mm-hmm. It takes like the 5 minute wait is probably 5 minutes to walk throughout the entire queue to end up by the boats. See, this entire queue winds its way in like this indoor area. It's actually pretty themed. You can see it here. And it goes all the way there.
They really make you
pretty crazy, yeah. They make you work for it, yeah, I agree. But this ride is really, this is my favorite. It's a Small World, probably tied with Paris. Tokyo's is pretty good too. The only one that really sucks is the Disney World. I'm sorry to the Disney World fans, it is not that good.
Okay,
It is almost 1:30 and we have done everything we wanted to ride while we were here. So we are just gonna hang out in the world of Frozen for about 3.5 hours and then slowly make our way out of the park. But we're gonna go here in a bit. Oh, there are toilets here. I didn't even know. We are in World of Frozen. And it is pretty.
Up to you guys.
We are inside the Golden Crocus Inn. It is gorgeous in here. Look at all the portraits of Anna and Elsa's kids, Queen Anna, Queen Elsa. Look at that. So we're here out at World of Frozen. Northern Delights is over there. We just came from Golden Crocus Inn and we have some food here. My sister got the
chicken with like ham and cheese, I think.
And I got the mushroom pasta. I really wanted to try everything in Frozen Land, so that included eating here. Let's see if it's good. Okay, so I have a spoonful over here. I'm gonna try it. Wow. That is good. It's so creamy. You can definitely taste the mushroom. This is very good food. Wow. That's delicious. There's Kristoff over there. So, we just finished lunch. It's currently 2:11. We're gonna go ride Frozen Ever After one last time. And then we're gonna go shopping. And then we're gonna go to Wonder Oak and Sliding Studies, do that. And I will film that for you guys. And then we're gonna buy some ice cream. And then have our show. And then take pictures. And then head to Main Street. In that order. In that specific, deliberate order. But this Golden Crocus food was really good. Yeah, would highly recommend. So this is the hoodie that I got. I was gonna get the spirit jersey as well, but I thought might as just get this one. I don't know, this just suits me more, I think. And there's a lot of merchandise. They have little, oh my god, they have shoulder plushes of Rumi. They have a bunch of Frozen things. All the Frozen things you could ask for. In one shop. There's Elsa. Oh my god! And it's Oaken! So, I'm on my way. Oh my god, can you see me? I have no idea. We are on our way back to Wandering Oaken Sliding Slice to ride it. It's probably gonna be our last ride of the day. After this, we're gonna get ice cream, walk around the land a little bit, and yeah. So I never got to show you guys the queue last time, so now we're gonna go through it a little bit. It's a very simple roller coaster, but I like it. Like for its size and length, it has a lot of thrills still, even though it's basically a kiddie coaster.
Ben and I were just talking about you. All good things, all good things.
We're done with our last ride of the day, so what's left to do is to just stroll around, take pictures, and soak in the view, which is gonna be very fun as well. This is Northern Delights. Where the, oh, look at this chocolate. We are getting from Northern Delights. So we got the Olaf cone. Let's see how it tastes. That is good. That is very good. So the next agenda is to just take pictures. As you can see, I am Anna.
I'm Elsa.
But yeah, we're gonna take pictures now.
Look, Mirror Lake.
It is Mirror Lake. So this is like a little area at the back of Frozen Land, of World of Frozen, I mean, where you kind of, it's this little path that you like walk around, and you can hear the different trolls talking to each other, especially in this particular area. And as you can see, there's a Bruni over there, looking very, very cute. Just a small little walkway, just for context, that's Wandering Oak and Sliding Slays. That's the Bay of Frozen. And that's where like Northern Delights is. These trolls are supposed to talk, but they ain't talking. These are trolls, right? Yes, they
Hello.
Are. Hello. Hello.
But Bruni's cute.
But there's Bruni, yeah.
Bruni's over there.
You know, I'm just guessing that his name's Bruni. I'm not even sure his name is Bruni. They never really gave him a name, but I think it's Bruni. I love the use of the mountains in the background to like make it look even more magnificent. Look at that. Although it's so backlit you can't probably see it. But. Just changed outfits. I'm now in my Hong Kong Disneyland spirit jersey along with some black pants. And yeah, we're gonna take pictures again. Leaving World of Frozen. It was a good time. We did a lot, saw everything except for Playhouse in the Woods, but that just gives us a reason to come back, I guess. And now we're just gonna head to the Dreammaker statue and take pictures with it, take pictures in front of the castle, and then head out. So this is the Dreammaker statue right behind the castle. It is golden hour here at Hong Kong Disneyland. And look at the castle of magical dreams. So pretty. Guys, I just found Mystic Manor socks. Literal Mystic Manor socks. Look at this. Of course I got some. They have Castle of Magical Dreams socks as well. Don't mind if I do. This is always my favorite room to shop at, mostly because of the Mickey over there who is an animator drawing something. This is pretty cool, guys. Oh, this is the spirit jersey I got. Has a nice Hong Kong Disneyland at the back. This is really nice. Look at that. There's a bunch of other things here. Here's the closer look at the Mickey. Just drawing away. Really love Main Street stores, they're the best. One last look at Main Street USA before we leave for the day. What a successful like morning and afternoon at Disneyland that was. We actually did, okay, you just can't see me right now. Let me try to fix that. Am I fixing it? No, never mind. You're gonna get this. There we go. It was a very successful day, I would say. We were able to do basically everything in Frozen Land. We ate at the restaurant, we rode both rides, we tried the ice cream, we looked at all the stores, and we bought stuff. And we just took pictures everywhere. We didn't do Playhouse in the Woods, but yeah, such a successful 8 hours at Hong Kong Disneyland. This park's only really open for 10 hours, but that was still great. I really wish I could have seen Momentous while I was here, because that's like my favorite Disney show, or one of my favorite Disney shows of all time. Up there with, what's that? Wondrous Journeys at Disneyland. But that was still very fun, and I can't wait for the next time I come back here, which will hopefully be very, very soon. But yes, we are making our way to the taxi stand, passing by the very iconic whale. And yeah, I think I'm just gonna end the vlog here. Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you like this vlog, comment down below and I will make more of them. I go back to LA in 2 days. And I go to Disneyland on the 28th of January. So if you wanna see vlogs from that, just tell me. And all the good things. And yeah, see you guys.